Okay, hi. So today I'm going to do barbie chain. Okay, so basically this is the first time I'm cooking the barbie chain. Okay, I got the recipe. Okay, so this is what I get. Okay, so basically the first thing is this pork belly. Okay, and the onion, the shallots. Okay, this one is mouth one. Okay, the garlic. Okay, coriander atau ketumbar, then cinnamon stick or bay manis, and this star anise, okay, bunga cengkeh, and tauchong. Okay, so basically you can add mushroom, bamboo shoot. Okay, but today I do a simple one. Okay, so basically it's just to have a feel of doing this. Well, this is my first time doing barbie chain. Okay. So now we start to cook the barbie chain. Okay, first thing is put the oil, cooking oil. Okay, almost same as pon te. So you told me okay for this one. Okay, we put the this kacang manis and bawang bunga cengkeh first. Okay, just cook this a while. Then onion. So now you can on the big fire until the whole thing hot, then we turn to small flame. Okay, this one will take quite a while. Okay, to mix. Okay, so now the onion is almost brown. Okay, now we add in the garlic. Okay, the next step. Okay, so if the smell is about there already, then we add in the garlic. Okay, then we stir fry again. So this may take about 10 to 20 minutes until the garlic turn brown and the smell come out. Okay, you can see usually I like to use a lot of shallot. Okay, the shallot is one thing is to bring out the smell. Second thing is to thicken the gravy. Okay, and the thing is to bring a bit of sweetness to the dish. Okay. Okay, so now this onion and the garlic is already almost done. Okay, then so now we add the tauchong. Okay, this one you have to fry it. Okay, to mix it. Okay, until the smell come out, or else the tauchong, if you don't fry to mix long enough, okay, the tauchong, the raw smell is very heavy and won't be so nice. Okay, so you have to mix until you know, the smell come out. Okay, so you can see, okay, so the smell is almost there already. Okay, now the smell of the tauchong, the onion, the garlic all out already. Okay, so the next thing is you mix with the sugar. Okay, so this sugar, as I mentioned earlier, for the ponte, same as ponte, okay, to make the color, make it a bit sweet, okay, to make the color and the caramel. Okay, so add in the sugar and you just mix. Okay, then make it, the thing is slightly darker. Okay, so normally I cook
this type of dish, I seldom or I hardly use black soya sauce. Okay, because why? Because the sugar, along the way when you simmer the time, okay, the color will become darker and darker because of the sugar. Okay, so this one, need to fry too long because the sugar will turn darker very fast. Okay, so after that, okay, this is a coriander. Okay, this is a ketumbar powder. Okay, you see the ketumbar I put the last. Okay, because ketumbar powder, we just add like that. Okay, when you fry the thing will turn bitter. Okay, so normally what we do is we put a bit of water, become a paste. Okay, to make it a paste. Okay, so you can do this thing, then we'll bring out the smell. Okay, because basically this ketumbar, they don't, normally those you buy from outside, they don't fry it. So they straight away, they just grind it, become a powder. Okay, so the smell is not there. Okay, so what you do is you make into paste. Okay, after you make into paste, then you pour it here. Then after that, you fry it until the thing, until the smell come out. Okay. Remember, don't put straight, put the powder to fry like that. Okay, it will be very bitter. Okay, then. You can see the color now is become darker already. Okay, basically for this dish, you need to put soya sauce. You need to put dark sauce. Okay, the saltiness, the tauchiu, and the caramel or the sugar, okay, from the sugar, okay, we make the whole thing dark, okay, and salty, and also the sugar also make the thing a bit sweet. So basically you can no need to put MSG or soy sauce. Okay, so now you can see it's almost done. Okay, the paste is almost done. Okay, so now you add in the pork belly. Okay, so same as ponte. Okay, you fry until the pork cook. Okay, so actually this is very important. Okay, you cannot straight away put water. You put water, the pork will be tasteless. Okay, so now together with rempa, okay, so you stir fry it until the pork is cooked. Then bit by bit you add in water. Okay.
So you see now the pork is outside is already cooked with this. Okay, you can see from here. Okay, so now you just add water. When you add water, you can turn on the fire. Then you stir again. Okay, as I mentioned just now,
okay, the water is add bit by bit. Or else all the smell will come out. Then okay, then it won't be so the nice smell no more, it'll be gone. Okay, bit by bit. So basically, you can add in bamboo shoot and shiitake mushroom or the black mushroom. Okay, but for this one, I just only use the pork. we can add some more water. So you can add in slightly more water. Okay, because when the thing simmers slowly, the thing will slowly dry up. Okay, and also the onion, the rempa, they will come up. Okay, so once it start boiling already, then turn your fire to very low fire. Okay, low fire. Okay, so now you see, so now it's already done. Okay, so it's the thing is already thick. Okay, you can try the pork, you see, when you just cut through, you can cut through already. Okay, yeah, can cut through. Oh, so that means it's already done. Okay, the thickness, the color. Okay, so without MHG, without without this soy sauce, without dark sauce, so the color is already darkened. Okay, so now we can get ready to serve. Okay, so here is the babichin. Okay, so if you want to add mushroom, okay, but this one is without the mushroom, without the bamboo shoot. Okay, some people they might like to add mushroom or bamboo shoot. Okay, so this is what we have now. Okay, and if because this is the first time and you have any feedback, okay, can you all can let me know whether this is the correct way. Okay, so I hope you enjoy the cooking session. Okay, see you again. Bye.